Okay, last year, September, I bought the bike. Immediately started planning, hashing out a trip with a friend of mine, Jeff. First trip we did, we went to Wainwright. And we had a lot of fun. So it wasn't long after that we decided we should probably start doing it again.
So I guess it had been about a year since Hamel and I had taken this trip to Wainwright, and we had such a good time, we knew we wanted to do another trip, maybe a couple of days. We didn't really know where, but we knew we wanted it to be, you know, about a week long, more or less camping off the bikes, while at the same time limiting what we had to pack by grabbing our food along the way.
So fast forward to January, February 2008. I'm in Rabbit Lake. It's minus 45 outside, and a motorcycle trip seems like a really good idea. Jeff's hip to the idea, so am I. So we start trying to figure out where we're going to go.
We didn't know where exactly we wanted to go. We both figured mountains would be nice, as Chris's from Saskatchewan, I'm from Alberta. Roads with a few twists and turns in them would be a pretty nice change.
All we really knew is that we just wanted to get out of town, out of the province, see some territory, that sort of thing.
Again, we didn't really know where we wanted to go. We thought the mountains would have been a nice place to start, just for the scenery and the challenging roads.
So Jeff and I spent a lot of time on MSN, trying to hash things out. Eventually we decided to go south, see some new territory.
Now from the start we agreed that whatever route we planned ahead of time would be completely fluid and subject to change at a moment's notice. We were very conscious of the fact that we didn't want to be pigeonholed into a very narrow view of the areas we wanted to see. But at least as a rough overshot, we kind of agreed on the following route. Heading southwest from Edmonton, we had to hit them as soon as possible, entering Banff National Park near Saskatchewan River Crossing. From there, we'd follow the mountains south towards the U.S. border. After crossing into the States, we'd hit the Going to the Sun Road in Glacier National Park, one of the highlights of the trip. From there, we'd cut the corner of Idaho and up into BC. In BC, we would stop and visit some friends of ours in Nelson before hitting the Grey Creek Pass and pointing our noses back east towards home.
So as we get a little closer to the trip, I'm away at work, mind you, up north. 800 kilometers from my bike. Hadn't ridden it in 2 months. Hop on the bike 3 days before the trip. Bloody thing won't start. So I hop onto KLR.net, Thumpers.com, ADV, ADSMC, you name it, I was there. Everyone said just take apart your carburetor. Great. How the hell do I do that? Luckily I had an appointment to get a new tire, otherwise there's no way I would have gotten into the dealership. Turns out the dealership screwed up. Couldn't get my tire in, but at least I had an appointment so they did my carburetor for me. $100 later I was on the road. Thank God. Let's do it!
So, we were finally on the road. It was nice to actually finally be moving, but it kind of sucked still being in the city. We had to dick around a little bit picking up a GPS mount before we finally hit the road. But once we got on the highway, boy, it was great.
After joining me in Edmonton from Saskatoon, Hammy and I would head southwest into Banff National Park through Sask River Crossing, spending the first night in a place called Mosquito Creek.
Stopped for fuel in Bentley and then pushed on. We could see a little bit of dark cloud in the distance. Kept going, had lunch in Nordegg, kind of a late lunch, and then we pushed on. Because it was the first day and you know we were still really feeling it, we wanted to get some miles under our belt and really didn't stop for much. Of course, once we came around the bend and saw Abraham Lake, we had to stop and fool around with the cameras for a bit. for the most part, the weather on the first day was great, mostly sunny for the first part of the day. It wasn't until we got to the park boundary at Banff National Park that the rain started. Despite its name, Mosquito Creek was a great little campground. Free firewood, $30 got us all the wood we wanted plus the spot. We weren't too far from the creek, it was within earshot, so we settled in for the night.
And here we are, home sweet home for night one. Give the folks a wave there, Hammy. Look at the lovely fire we made with soaking wet wood.
Sexy.